What's going on, everybody? It's Mickey Indigo here with another one. You already know, if you're new here, go ahead, like, and subscribe. Oh, man. I have to start off by saying, if you boycotted In the Heights because there was a lack of Black Latinx inclusivity, you're an idiot. I shouldn't say that, right?
No.
I guess I shouldn't say that. But I really do believe that. I really do. Look, you're entitled to your beliefs. But majority of the people that I've seen that actually have a problem with it aren't even Black Latinx people. like they're talking for them. You know what I'm saying? Newsflash. I mean, I got a Black Latinx father. And, you know, we watched a movie. And I waited until after the movie and asked him. I was like, hey, look. Are you offended that we just watched this movie? He's like, well, what do you mean? Why should I be offended? He's like, all defensive. You know, he's like, why should I be offended? What happened? And I was like, cuz there's a big controversy right now talking about even Lin-Manuel Miranda went and apologized. Now, look, it is my personal belief that he apologized because he has a Disney contract. But let me tell you, I have no Disney contract. So I will be there for Lin-Manuel where I know he can't stand right there and talk. I'm going to say it. Like I said, my Black Latinx dad did not have any problem watching the movie. As a matter of fact, he really enjoyed the movie a lot. And I'll be honest, man, we don't need people talking for other people, talking about how those other people are offended. What do you think?
I'm a little confused about the whole situation. I thought the movie was to kind of represent all Spanish, and it doesn't matter if it's, you know, Spanish from, I don't know, like from Spain or Spanish from America or Spanish. That's what,
well,
I believe.
I think the controversy is that there's no Black Latinx speaking roles.
What is this Black Latin?
That's probably another terminology that a Latin person did not come up with. But, you know, for the sake of just saying it, that's where the controversy lies. But you know what I'm saying? That means that there was no Latin person, whether, you know, female, male, otherwise, it don't matter. You know, there were no speaking roles for them.
But how do you, just enlighten me a little bit here. How do Black Latin people speak? I'm confused.
How do they speak?
Yeah, like...
Like you and me. They talk normal. It's just the fact that there were no people with a darker skin complexion, I guess, who happened to also be Hispanic featured in speaking roles. Now, I think this is a silly controversy. I think it's literally came out of nowhere. Look, if I had my conspiracy theory hat on, I would think this is like Steven Spielberg coming up with a campaign to go ahead and sabotage these, you know, Latino people trying to make this Latin movie because West Side Story is coming out. I'm just being cynical. That's probably not what's going on. I'm just saying. But look, I'm gonna be honest, man. The real controversy and the thing that you should be, you know, honestly focusing on is the class warfare. Not necessarily the racial warfare. I feel like these campaigns are made to go ahead and, you know, distract you, you know, because people who are gullible are going to go ahead and, you know, they'll go ahead, boycott it, not even seeing the movie, not even knowing. You look, Latinos, Hispanics, they barely have anything. They barely have any characters in the MCU. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, they're barely talked about. They're barely featured. I've never seen any, you know, TV show or movie where, you know, there's a Hispanic American that actually speaks English who's the main character. Have you?
No.
Not, I haven't.
But isn't it Puerto Ricans and Dominicans like half Black if we go to the race?
Yeah, but it's literally about the color of their skin. I guess that's where the controversy is coming from.
Are you sure?
I think so. I mean, that's how silly it sounds, right? It sounds that silly. And I understand, like, okay, if you're, like, let's say a Black Latinx person and you legitimately feel upset about this situation, like, literally reevaluate what's going on. The fact that there's actual movie being, you know, shown of, you know, maybe you yourself isn't being shown, but look, Hispanics and Latinos, they're not, you know, featured anywhere. Not that anyone's really whining about it. You know what I'm saying? Not that anyone's even complaining about it. But when they have some little thing, when they have a little thing that's good for them, it gets destroyed. Like, it's just crazy by a silly controversy that's not even coming from them, largely, I feel like, at least, according to my, you know, the biggest reference is my dad. You know, I mean, he thought that was silly. He thinks the whole controversy's complete bullcrap. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, Lin had to go ahead and apologize. He has contracts with Disney he has to uphold. If he doesn't do something, does some kind of damage control, they'll go ahead and cut him off. You know what I mean? Just like they've done with everyone else in the past. So, yeah. It is what it is, man. I just had to lay this to rest, man, because, look, like I said, Latinos have nothing. And if you want to go ahead and trash them on some silly, nonsensical campaign where the actual issue is a class warfare rather than a racial warfare, you know, screw you, man. You're just kind of like falling into the pond, right? You're just kind of falling into this fake conspiracy that, you know, and I get it, man. The youth is a little bit more gullible than, you know, the older people. Not that the youth isn't smart. Of course, they're more smart, but they're more susceptible to being used, man. And I was right there when I was a kid, too, you know. Yeah. I listened to mainstream music, and I would listen, and I had my days. But look, don't be used, man. Don't be used, whether you're Black Latinx or, you know, gay, lesbian, whatever. Don't be a pawn. Do not be a pawn. And that's all I have to say.
Yeah.
Now, what do you think?
I mean, honestly, it's a silly subject. I don't see there is something where I have to kind of like give my point of view. I didn't know what was the problem to begin with. Hispanic, it's a Hispanic Latino movie, so everyone is represented there.
Yeah, I mean,
in general.
It is what it is, man. I'm a little frustrated. I'm a little salty. It took me quite a little bit for me to come out with this video and actually talk about it because...
I mean, honestly, we live now in a world where everything is kind of like everyone feels sensitive somehow. So I don't want you to feel like sad about it, but...
Yeah, no, I mean, I'm not that upset, but I need to say something.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Don't crap all over the little things that we have.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And it was a good movie.
It was a fantastic movie. Made absolutely no money. Surprise. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is, man. What, do I foresee Hollywood making any more Spanish-centric movies? No. Because of this. So it is what it is, man. Like I said, we're not going to go cry and complain about it. It's just, you know, had to be said. I'm Mickey Indigo.
Minal.
And y'all already know. That's a wrap. If you enjoyed this content, please like, share, and subscribe. Your continued support will keep this show going.